evening. Oh, there we go. Good evening. I'm so glad that you have come out to support our children as they praise God and teach us new things about God. It is going to be a wonderful evening, and I just want to take a moment to say thank you to Trinity and her whole crew of people that are teaching these kids how to love Jesus through song. So Trinity, thank you for what you are doing tonight. Yay. And sit back and enjoy.
Thank you. used for this play.
We are here to tell a story that happened long ago and far away.
Although the Bible doesn't say that shepherds ever sneeze, the message here is more than that. So listen, if you please.
Come back with us to Bible times on that special holy night.
When God came down to earth to show we're precious in his sight.
No matter what the ups and downs or challenges we face,
God brings peace and love to us, and amazing is his grace.
Yes, that's enough. The players have arrived, you see. The choir is rehearsed and set.
So first things first. Turn off your phones and funny ringtones, and no one will get upset.
Yes, that's enough now to get things started. You'll hear more all along.
So first things first, let's make some music.
And sing the opening song. Welcome now to Bethlehem. Out here in this field is Aaron, the allergic shepherd.
Achoo!
God bless you.
God bless you.
God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you.
You see, Aaron is allergic to sheep.
The only thing worse than a shepherd who's allergic to sheep would be a sheep who's allergic to wool.
But that's another story for another time.
My boss, the head shepherd, Mr. Ivy Lambshop, says,
if you don't stop sneezing, Aaron, I'll have to fire you.
If you don't stop sneezing, Aaron, I have to fire you. I don't want to do that. We can't have a shepherd that's allergic to sheep.
Why not?
Because it tends to make them nervous. And we can't have a nervous sheep. They seem to wander off looking for greener pastures.
Yes, Mr. Ivy.
Sent out a decree.
What?
Oh, he made a law that everyone had to be counted so they could be taxed.
Too bad he couldn't have used this choir as deductions.
What?
What?
Oh, never mind. Too much is going on. Caesar and his taxes, me and my, achoo! Me and my sneezing. I just wish things could be easier. Why can't life be perfect? Why can't I be perfect?
Thank you. God bless you.
God bless you.
You got it. The other shepherds wouldn't. You got it. The other shepherds wouldn't let Aaron go to Bethlehem because of his sneezing.
But hope was born on that night when Jesus came to us. Everything changed.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
I would like to see Jesus and worship him, but I have no gift for him, and his sneezing might make him nervous, like the sheep.
You don't need to take anything special to Jesus. Just give yourself, and as you trust him, worship him, and forget about yourself, he'll take care of your problems in his way and time. It's time to end our play.
Aaron didn't get rid of his sneezing, but God showed him a different way.
A Jew!
God bless you!
God bless you!
Mr. Ivy Lampshop put me in the front office doing paperwork, and I'm not allergic to paper. At least not yet.
Thank you for listening as we present this tour de force.
Remember what we said before, our play had run its course.
No matter what the ups and downs and challenges you face,
God brings peace and love to us, and amazing is his grace.
So even though life isn't perfect, this we know is true.
Emmanuel, God is with us, even if we don't know what to do.
So we celebrate the coming of our hope and guiding light.
Our play is done. Celebrate God's Son.
All is calm and all is bright.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming. They did a great job. They have worked very, very hard. They've been working on this play since the last week of September. This cast is very young. Our oldest child is Safira. She is in the third grade. And then we have Braden Zeebach, who is a second grader, our Aaron, the allergic shepherd. And then we have a bunch of first graders, kindergartners, and preschoolers. So for such a young cast, they, I think, did a phenomenal job. So thank you all so much for coming out, and we hope you have a very Merry Christmas. Come back and see us next Sunday. We have lessons and carols, and then Christmas Eve, of course, on December 24th at 5 o'clock. Is it 5 o'clock? We would love to have you. This is a great church. If you don't have a home, come join us.